I hope you are having a blessed day. My name is Malkia.
My name is Ahadi.
And let's pray. Thank you, dear God, for this day. Please protect us. Please help us in everything we are going to do. Thank you for this Sunday. Thank you for all the children in the world as we learn about your birth of Christ. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
Let us join the praise and worship team. Thank you.
Hello, boys and girls. Good morning and welcome to today's lesson. This is the day the Lord has made. This is the day.
This is the day that the Lord has made.
That the Lord has made.
We will rejoice.
Woo!
We will rejoice and be glad in it.
Oh, yes.
Thank you so much, Shadi and Shali. You are part of our lesson today. But before we start the lesson, I want us to pray. Let us put our hands together and pray. Dear God, thank you for today. Thank you for today's lesson. We pray, please help us to pay attention and to learn something new about Jesus. This we pray to God in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Again?
Amen.
Thank you very much. We want to see some of the work you did last week. Some of you sent in your work. Let us see the good work that you did.
I love the Bible.
Oh, yes.
I love the Bible because I read it and I do it. I read it and I do it. I love the Bible. I love the Bible because I read it and I do it.
Oh. Thank you so much, Shirley and Shadi. That was great. Children, do you love the Bible? Do you read it? Do you do it? Do you obey what is here? My name is Teacher Brenda, and today's lesson is The Promised Savior. The Bible is a very wonderful book. Do you have one?
Mm-hmm. Teacher Brenda, I have a Bible.
You do?
Mm-hmm.
Do you read it?
Yes.
Oh, I thought you didn't know how to read, because some children don't yet know how to read. But if you don't know how to read, your mommy or your daddy or whoever can read for you the Bible. The Bible is God's word, and it's full of many, many promises of God, many promises he has given. Today, I want us to think of the promise, and we're going to learn of this very special promise of the Savior. The promise was given by God. You see, boys and girls, the Bible has two parts. There's the Old Testament,
and the New Testament.
Ah, you know that!
Yes!
Let's clap.
My mommy told me.
Excellent! You see, the difference is the Old Testament has many stories, and it was written before Jesus Christ was born. And the stories there tell us, starting with Adam and how Adam disobeyed God and sin came into the world. And the punishment of sin came. Do you like telling lies, for example?
No.
So you never tell lies?
No.
Oh, you're good children. Do you sometimes fight?
Yes.
I got you. Yeah. So some of these bad things, terrible things that displease God are written in the Old Testament. But you see, God wasn't so happy to see the people that he made fight and kill each other, steal from one another, tell lies, disobey God. He didn't like it. So he decided he was going to send a savior. Say that word with me.
Savior.
Again?
A savior.
Very good. What was the savior going to do? He was going to... Shadi, can you guess what the savior was to do?
Teacher Brenda?
Yeah.
He was going to save the people of the earth.
From what, Shadi?
From their sins.
Very good, Shadi. You got it. From their sin and the punishment. You know, because sin is punished, eh? Yeah, so he was going to remove the punishment of this sin and the power of this sin from their lives. So he spoke, God spoke in the Old Testament before even Jesus was born. God already spoke. And he told some people called prophets. Say prophets.
Prophets.
I'm looking at, yes, Shadi.
What's a prophet?
What is a prophet? Who is a prophet? Mm-hmm. A prophet is somebody that God gives a message about things that are to happen long before they happen. It tells us that God knows the future. You see? And so this word remained with prophets because God did not want people to be confused when the Savior came. He spoke to them and told the prophets exactly what was to happen and when.
Oh, Teacher Brenda.
Yes, Shirley.
So God knows what will happen tomorrow on Monday.
Oh, yes, he does.
Oh.
He knows what will happen tomorrow, the day after tomorrow, the day after tomorrow, and many years to come. He does know. And he has already told us in the Bible.
Teacher Brenda.
Yes, please, Shadi.
Who are prophets?
Prophets. Mm-hmm. These are messengers of God who speak about what is to come in the future. You see, Shadi, Shirley, and children at home, God gave a lot of promises and his word is recorded in the Bible. Two prophets spoke about Jesus. In fact, many more did, but I just want to talk about two. One of them was called Micah. Can you say Micah?
Micah.
Oh, yes. Micah the prophet, God told him that the promised Savior would be born in a town called Bethlehem. Can you say Bethlehem?
Bethlehem.
So when they looked for a Savior, they expected this son, this boy, this Savior to be born in the town of Bethlehem, in the tribe of Judah, and he was going to be a ruler. Another prophet, God gave him a message telling him, even before Jesus was born, he said to him that this promised Savior was going to be born in a very miraculous way. He was to be born of a virgin, a woman who has never lived or known a man. Yeah, this was going to be a miraculous happening. Something that has never, ever happened before. Don't you find that just so different?
Yeah.
Because God sees into the future. So when the child was born, when this Savior came, it was easy for people to know this is him. Because this was already promised by God and it is written in his word. Shadi and Shirley, does God keep his promise?
I think he does.
Yeah? Good. Let us see. I want us to watch a short clip and then we will talk about what we have seen.
In the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent from God to a city of Galilee named Nazareth, to a virgin betrothed to a man whose name was Joseph of the house of David. And the virgin's name was Mary. And he came to her and said, "Hail, O favored one, the Lord is with you. blessed are you among women. But when she saw him, she was troubled at his saying, and considered in her mind what manner of greeting this was. And the angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. And behold, you will conceive in your womb and bring forth a son, and you shall call his name Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Highest. And the Lord God will give to him the throne of his father David. And he will reign over the house of Jacob forever. And of his kingdom there will be no end." And Mary said to the angel,
"How shall this be, since I do not know a man?"
And the angel answered and said to her, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Highest will overshadow you. Therefore, the Holy One who is to be born will be called the Son of God. And behold, your kinswoman Elizabeth has also conceived a son in her old age, and this is the sixth month with her who was called barren. For with God, nothing will be impossible." And Mary said,
"Behold, the maidservant of the Lord, let it be to me according to your word."
And the angel departed from her.
Shali and Shadi, I enjoyed what I watched in that clip. Did you?
Yes.
Shali, what was the name of that angel?
Angel Gabriel.
Very good. And what did Angel Gabriel say, Shadi?
He told Mary that he's going to have a son.
Yes, she was going to have a son. Remember, this is the same promise that we were told about by the prophet long before it happened, Prophet Isaiah in the Old Testament. You see, now the time had come and the angel went to tell Mary just what God had said, because he's God who keeps his promise. Now, children, boys and girls, I know that there are times when your parents do give you promises, don't they?
Yes.
Maybe they tell you they're going to give you a birthday party, or they will take you out, and then your face is like that. You are so happy and you're smiling because you're looking forward and you're all happy. So we too should be glad because God keeps his promise. Sometimes our parents might forget. Maybe they don't have money the way they planned to. They cannot carry out the plan. Sometimes they do keep their word, I know. But always when our promise is fulfilled, we are so very glad. We just have a happy face. Can you smile?
Yay!
Shali, I want to see you smile.
Shali, have a smiley face.
Shali has a smiley face, yeah? Oh, that's very good. Now, children, what happens when we believe this promise of a savior from God? What happens? Would you like to know what happens?
Mm-hmm.
You see, the Bible says that whoever believes that Jesus is the Son of God, that person, when they believe and they confess with their mouth that this Jesus is the Christ, is the Son of God, they can become a member of God's family. Would you like to call God your father? And those who believe in the Savior Jesus Christ mm-hmm. can be your brothers and your sisters in the family of God. You see, the Father sent the Son to be the Savior of the world. It's written in the Bible, in the New Testament, 1 John chapter 4 and verse 14. The Bible says, the Father sent the Son to be the Savior of the world. We can sing it like this. The Father sent the Son to be the Savior of the world. Together.
The Father sent the Son to be the Savior of the world.
Again.
The Father sent the Son to be the Savior of the world.
That's our memory verse for today. It comes from 1 John chapter 4 and verse 14. The Father sent the Son to be the Savior of the world. Would you like Jesus, the Son of God, to be your Savior? You see, God promised to send us a Savior to save us from our sin and the punishment of that sin, so that we are rescued from the punishment of sin, which is separation from God. God loves us so much. He has already given us Jesus. Boys and girls, He has given us Jesus Christ. If we believe in Him and we ask Him to come into our hearts and we ask Him also to forgive us our sins, He will forgive us. He is the promised Savior. Let us pray together. Close your eyes, boys and girls. We want to pray and ask Jesus to forgive us and to come into our hearts. Pray with me. Say, Dear Lord Jesus.
Dear Lord Jesus.
I have heard. That you are. The promised Savior. Please forgive me my sins.
Help me.
To be a good child. To obey you. To obey my parents.
I pray.
Please come into my heart.
And make me a child of God.
I pray in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen, boys and girls. Those of you who have prayed this prayer, God has forgiven your sins. And you have become a child of God, and you can pray calling God, Father. Our Father who is in heaven, and you have become a member of the family of God. Thank you, boys and girls, for you have learned this day about the promised Savior. Next week, make sure you follow the lesson so that you know how was the promise fulfilled? How did this promise come to be? Make sure you're there. Until next